Hello everyone. In the previous video, we have discussed about algorithm 3, that is a short-term hydrothermal scheduling using penalty factor. So let us do one numerical today based on the same algorithm. So those who have not seen the video, the link for the same video is given in the iCard above. You can check it up. So let us see the numerical for algorithm 3. Now, how to identify whether the given numerical is based on algorithm 2 or 3? The algorithm 2, what we have discussed is short-term hydrothermal scheduling using gamma lambda iterations. And the third one which we have seen is same short-term hydrothermal scheduling using penalty factor. See, when we discussed a second algorithm, the very important factor there is it's an iteration process. So when we say it is an iteration process, we need tolerances values. So in the algorithm also we have seen the tolerance values are necessary. But here in the third algorithm, since it is not an iteration process, so it is one step process, so we don't need any tolerance. So in the numerical, tolerance will not be given. So let me take the numerical. So you can see here, a steam plant and a hydro plant supply a load of 500 megawatt for 12 hour and 300 megawatt for 12 hour. So in a day, first 12 hours are having a 500 megawatt load. So this will be PD value for the 12 hour. And the remaining 12 hour PD value is 300. So that's okay, we can split and then we can calculate. The main very important thing what we have to calculate here is scheduling. Scheduling is nothing but calculating PGH and PGT. That is nothing but the power generated by thermal plant and power generated by hydro plant. So when the numerical is splitted like this for 12 hour and 12 hour, don't worry, first you take this and calculate PGT and PGH for the first 12 hour, then you take PD as this, then you calculate PGH and PGT for the remaining 12 hours. So that's fine. And what are the given data? The thermal plant characteristics are given by, so cost function is given for the thermal plant, this is a cost function, and hydro plant is characterized by Q, that is a water discharge. So we know the constraint, that is why these two characteristics are given. For thermal, that is cost function, and for hydro, it is water discharge. Along with that, the loss is given. Why loss is given? Because while using penalty factor algorithm, we need a penalty factor calculation, which is mainly based on the loss equation. So the loss equation is given. And obviously, it's a gamma lambda iteration, method. So I'll not say it is iteration, it is a gamma lambda method using penalty factor. So it is gamma value has to be given, so gamma is 80. So what we need? So we need scheduling of power, that is PGT is what and PGH is what, and the total discharge is Q. Also determine the daily operating cost of the thermal plant and the water used daily by the hydro plant. So once we get PGH and PGT, we can substitute here and we can calculate cost and water discharge. That's fine. Obtain the schedule. First one is neglecting losses and the second one is by considering losses. So two times we have to do the same scheduling. First scheduling is for neglecting losses and the second scheduling is by considering losses. So let us see the flow, the program, the numerical flow. So in the previous algorithm we have seen the coordination equation for both the plants. So for hydro power plant, so this is hydro power plant, we have written coordination equation as gamma dq naught by dpgh 1 by 1 minus dou P loss with respect to dou PGH. So this is what, this is a penalty factor we have taken, and the this is nothing but coordination equation which equals to lambda, and the same thing can be replaced by gamma and this I'll write IH. So what is IH? IH is incremental water rate. I've explained all these in the previous algorithm, incremental water rate. And what is LH? LH is penalty factor for hydro plant. Now why we have to multiply gamma here? So the same substitution we have done, but to convert incremental water rate to incremental cost, this multiplication is done. That's fine. So remember this equation. And also for thermal plant, the coordination equation is this, dFT with respect to dPgT, and the penalty factor for the same, which is equal to lambda. And this can be equated as IT, which is incremental cost of thermal plant. LT is penalty factor for thermal plant. See, remember we have here gamma extra, here there is no such multiplier. Why? Because IH is incremental water rate. To convert it into incremental cost, we are multiplying gamma. But whereas here we directly get incremental cost into penalty factor. Okay, now here let me first consider the first case, that is neglecting loss. So if I neglecting loss, so these terms will not be there, that is LT will not be there. So what we write is, from this equation, it is gamma dQ naught by dPgH. This is not there, so it is 1 will be equal to lambda, and this equation becomes dFT dPgT. This is 1, since this value is 0, is equal to lambda. The other side, this equivalent terms I'll not write because I need to find out what are these. So this is neglecting loss. Now we'll make use of these equations and we'll find out the scheduling. So for this, what we need, see, we need gamma. Gamma is already known, which is given as 80 in the question itself. And we have Q naught equation. So Q naught equation is here. So we can calculate the differentiation of this with respect to PGH. That is what we need here. So that is fine. And we need lambda. Similarly, dFT, dPGT, which is equal to lambda. We can compare both these and we can calculate the value of PGT and PGH. See, this is equal to lambda, this is equal to lambda. So we can compare both this. Before that, we'll find out what are these values. So gamma is, we know it is 80 given. Q naught or Q, which is given as 0.003 PGH square plus 0.5 PGH. 0.5 PGH. This is given. So what will be dQ naught dPgH? So we have to differentiate this with respect to PGH. So this is a 2 into 0.003 PGH. That is 0.006 PGH. And when I differentiate this with respect to PGH, it is just 0.5. So we have this. And also this we need. So let us first write what is FT. So what is FT? FT is nothing but the cost of thermal power plant characteristic. It is given. So 0.06 PGT square plus 40 PGT plus 100. So 40 PGT plus 100. So what we need is dFT with respect to PGT is equal to, so let me write this, 1, 2 PGT, differentiating with respect to PGT, plus 40, that's it. So this is the second equation. Now, so from this, let me take this as 1, let me take this as 2, comparing 1 and 2. Why we are comparing? Because both the equations are equal to lambda. Comparing the equations. So I'll write this is equal to this. So what is gamma? Gamma is 80. So 80 into what is this? This is 0.006 PGH plus 0.5 is equal to this, that is DFT with respect to DPGT. What is that? So here it is. So it is 0.12 PGT plus foot. Now what we need is PGT and PGH value. So how to simplify this? See, in the given question, we have one more data with us, which is nothing but P loss. Anyways, we have neglected P loss, so that is not needed for us. What are the remaining data? We have PD value. So first, I will take PD as 500. So what is PD? Let me write here. So now, first case, when PD is equal to 500 megawatt. So if PD is 500 megawatt, that is the load, I can write PD is equal to PGH plus PGT. Is that correct? Yes. Why? Because neglecting losses. Neglecting losses. So if I neglect losses, I can write PD is equal to the generation. Generation is PGH plus PGT. If I consider losses, I have to write PD plus P loss is equal to PGH plus PGT. So anyways, we have neglected the loss. So I can write this. So I can write 500 is equal to PGH plus PGT. So now in place of PGT, I can write 500. So what is this PGT implies? PGT is equal to 500 minus PGH, or you can write PGH is equal to 500 minus PGT. So anyone you can take. So this you substitute here. So what we are doing is either we have to substitute for PGH in terms of PGT or PGT in terms of PGH. So what I have is after this 0.006 PGH plus 0.5 is equal to 0.12. In place of PGT, I'll be writing this. That is 500 minus PGH plus 40. So this is done. Now simplify this. Simplify this. So you'll be getting value of PGH. PGH. So PGH value will be somewhere around 100 megawatt. You check this calculation. So 100 megawatt. So this numerical I've taken from Power System Operation and Control, Uma Rao textbook. So if any mistake in the calculation, you just verify it, and you can either put it in the comment box or you can mail me. So let me check that. So these are the answers given in the textbook. So you check the calculation. If any mistakes, you let me know. So PGH will be getting 100 megawatt. Now what is PGT? So substitute here. So PGT will be equal to, PGT here will be equal to 500 minus 100. So it gives us 400 megawatt. So we have calculated scheduling, neglecting losses, and for the load 500 megawatt. Now if PD is 300 megawatt, what is scheduling? It is similar. So you just take PD as 300 is equal to PGH plus PGT. Everything will be similar to the previous one. Just a substitute. So PGT is what from this? PGT will be equal to 300 minus PGH. So substitute in the equation. So it is 80 into 0.006 PGH plus 0.5 is equal to 0.12. In place of PGT, we are writing 300 minus PGH plus 40. So what we'll be getting, if I simplify this, PGH will be equal to 60 megawatt and PGT will be equal to 300 minus 60 megawatt, that is 240 megawatt. So we have calculated the scheduling, that is done. So find the scheduling of power and the total discharge. Okay, scheduling is done. Now what we need is determine the daily operating cost of the thermal plant and the water used daily by the hydro plant. See, this gives you the daily operating cost. Yeah. One more thing here, the cost function, this is a cost function, and this gives you for cost for hour, 1 hour. So we have to calculate the operating cost for 24 hours. Why it is 24 hours? Because it is daily operating cost. So let us see. And again, while calculating the daily operating cost, the same equation you have to consider twice. Why? Because the scheduling for first 12 hours is different, scheduling for second 12 hours is different. That is what we have found out in the calculation. So according to that, you have to go. So let us calculate the daily operating cost. So daily operating cost of thermal plant. Thermal plant. So what is the cost function given? So FT is given. This is FT, which is given by 0.06 PGT square plus 40 PGT plus it is 100. So unit cost per hour. So for 12 hours I have to multiply. So let me write, for 12 hours PGT is what? First 12 hours PGT we have calculated by considering PD as 500 megawatt, PGT is 400 megawatt. So 400 megawatt. So for 12 hours, remaining 12 hours PGT we have calculated, which is nothing but 240 megawatt. That is by considering load as 300 megawatt. Okay. So total cost FT will be equal to 0.06 PGT square for the first 12 hours. What is that? So it is 400. So into 400 square plus 40 into 400 plus 100. So this gives me per hour into 12 I have to make, because for the first 12 hours, plus the remaining, that is 0.06 into PGT is what now? 240. So 240 square plus 40 PGT, 240 plus 100 into 12. Why it is 12? For the remaining 12 hours. So this gives us 325,267 unit cost. So it is not given whether it is rupees, dollars or any other unit. So we'll take unit cost only. So this is for a day, or daily cost. So this we have calculated. Now what is the second calculation we have to do? So the second one is the water used daily by the hydro plant. So this is a water plant characteristic, hydro plant characteristic. So let us take this and we'll calculate. So Q is 0.03. So water. So what is that? Water used daily by the hydro plant. So water used daily by the hydro plant. So Q is equal to 0.003 PGH square plus 0.5 PGH meter cube per second. This is the equation given. See, look at this carefully. Here the unit is meter cube per second. Since we have calculated scheduling for hours, that is first 12 hours and second 12 hours, we need to convert this first to hour. Then later on we have to substitute the scheduling. So how to convert this into hour? So 1 second is how much hour? So 1 hour is, we know it is 3600 seconds. So 1 second is, that is 1/3600 R. So Q will be equal to 0.003 pgh² plus 0.5 pgh meter cube. 1 second is 1/3600 R. Now I can take this to the numerator. So what does this give? So it is 0.003 pgh² plus 0.5 pgh. The entire thing into 3600. Be careful here, don't multiply this only to the second term, it is for the entire term, to 3600 meter cube per hour. Now this is fine for us. Now you make use of the scheduling value of pgh. So for the first 12 hours, what is the scheduling value we have calculated? Pgh is equal to, it is 100 megawatt. And for next 12 hours, what is the pgh value we have calculated? It is 60 megawatt. So we'll substitute that and we'll calculate Q. So Q will be equal to total water used daily, that is for 24 hours. Q will be equal to 0.003 for the first 12 hours, 100. So 100 square plus 0.5 into 100 into 12. Why you are making into 12? Because it is for first 12 hours and the equation gives for 1 hour into 3600. Why this 3600 has come? That is because we have converted meter cube per second into meter cube per hour, plus 0.003 into 60 square, second scheduling, plus 0.5 into 60 into 12 into 3600. So this gives you Q value as 5.218 into 10 to the power 6 meter cube for 1 day. Okay, is that clear? So this is how we calculate. Now what we have done is only the first half we have calculated. See, neglecting losses. By considering losses, how to calculate? So considering losses, you can do it with a similar method, but only thing is you need penalty factor. So how to, which equation to be used? You use this equation, these two equations, by considering this. So you first calculate this value and this value, then substitute here in these equations, compare it and find out the values. So I hope the second half can be done by you. It is simple, similar way you have to do, but take these two equations. So find out, okay, let me first do the penalty factor calculation so that you can continue with the rest. So considering losses, so what is P loss equation we have written? So P loss equation is 0.001 pgh² is that correct? Yeah, P loss is 0.001 pgh². So this is a P loss equation. So we need a P loss with the pgh. So what is this? So it gives us 0.002 pgh. Now what is partial derivative of this with respect to pgt? So we don't have any pgt term here, so partial derivative will be 0. So once we calculate this, it goes similar way. So first equation becomes gamma is 80 dq naught dpgh 1/1 minus, what is this, this is 0.002 pgh is equal to lambda. And the second equation becomes dft dpgt. So it is 1 by 1 minus 0, it is 1 is equal to lambda. Now we have this as first equation, this as second equation, compare both and you do the calculation. If any difficulty, you can just put that in the comment box so that I can answer it. Okay, so that's it for today. So thank you.